What's up YouTube? I'm Valentin the Mad, and this is a good review of Hotline Miami 2. Often when you play a good single player game, the first one or two levels are what I call foreplay. They give you one of the smaller weapons to play around with, and it takes some time before you get to the really messy stuff. That is not the case with Hotline Miami 2. Pretty much as soon as you get control of your character, you will see the gore system in all its glory. And despite the pixelated graphics, I must say that my first response to that was, whoa. So yes, Hotline Miami 2 is indeed quite gory. But how gory exactly? Let's find out. I'll be reviewing every aspect of the game's gore effects, and the score will be set based on 4 categories. Body damage, environment, animations and sounds, the fuel. The vast majority of characters in the game die from one hit, so all of the body damage is basically a bunch of gory variations based on the weapon you're using. And despite the graphics being pixelated, those variations actually look very creative and cool. Some include beheadings, limbs dismemberment, insides coming outside, or just the character cut in half. The amount of variations is generally good. You will see them repeat, but they don't really get old. I want to note the executions. Even though you have only one execution move per melee weapon, they are cool as hell and feel very satisfying. There is one issue though. There are certain special characters in the game that don't respond like your average enemy. Some of them can't be killed by melee and will keep going for a few seconds even after taking a few bullets. Others can't be killed by gunfire. While they are not exactly the bullet sponges I'm talking about in the other reviews, I still found them to be very irritating. The fact that the player is as vulnerable as the NPCs is one of my favorite things about the game. You have to think fast, act fast, one wrong move, and you're a bleeding gory variation yourself. So having characters with weird kill conditions is not something I found to be fun. You have blood splatter for the attacks, blood pools under dead characters, and inner organs spread around. The environment aspect is the most notable feature in the gore system of Hotline Miami 2, and for a good reason. Every attack you perform spreads red paint everywhere. It is definitely over the top, but the result actually looks right. And it's not just blood. You will be seeing torn off limbs, muscle tissue, inner organs, and brain matter. The outcome of your average fight is just absolutely beautiful. And while the mess is pretty damn great, there is one major issue that you have probably noticed from the beginning of the review, or from pretty much any video that has footage of the game. Blood and bodies don't respond to physical barriers at all. They will be going through walls as though they don't exist. It is not a bug or a rare occurrence. Walls simply stop being a factor the very moment that the enemy dies. Yes, it is as bad as it sounds. Now I can get why blood isn't staining furniture in this type of a game, and I don't mind that too much. But I don't think that expecting bodies to have at least some kind of interaction with walls is a wild idea. But hey, maybe I'm getting it all wrong, and this is actually a deep commentary on gaming. Do not try to go through the wall. That's impossible. Instead, only try to realize the truth. There is no wall. Now, how is the mess in the long term? Basically, as good as it can be. Literally nothing disappears. Bodies, blood, organs, and even the bullet shells and broken glass. That, along with the totally exaggerated blood spitting mechanics, deliver an amazing aftermath experience. There is very little emphasis on animations in Hotline Miami 2. On most attacks, it's an insta-kill and the enemies get thrown back or to the sides. Death animations are very uncommon and happen only for specific weapons or characters. Now, for the most part, it actually works for this game. The lack of animations didn't stand out to me as a flaw, but I do think that there is a lot of room for improvement in that aspect. And let me explain. There is one animation that can happen after you hit someone with a blunt object. They will crawl for a bit with a wound on their head while leaving a blood trail. That is the only animation of this kind that I encountered in the game, and it's a shame, because this animation is absolutely awesome. My suggestion would be to have a lot more of those animations for all the weapons in the game. Insta-death should be much less common. What we should be seeing instead is enemies wiggling on the ground, crawling, or maybe even running around with a missing arm while bleeding all over the place. As for the sounds, you have respawn sounds on impact, and that's it. In my playthrough of Hotline Miami 2, I don't think that I heard human voice a single time. I didn't really have high expectations on that for my pixelated game, but it does make the sound aspect feel empty. The respawn sounds for melee attacks aren't bad though. They are nothing exceptional, but they do the job. Hotline Miami 2 feels pretty good. The body damage has gory and creative variations. The environment aspect is mostly awesome. The aftermath experience is exceptional. And the animations and sounds kind of work for this type of a game. There are a few issues and there is room for improvement, but all in all, Hotline Miami 2 feels very responsive. So the score for body damage is 8 out of 30. The score for environment is 18 out of 30. The score for animations and sounds is 7 out of 30. I give the feel a score of 7 out of 10. So this gives Hotline Miami 2's gore system a total score of 40 out of 100. Hotline Miami 2 is very enjoyable and has a solid core system for its graphical style with very few major issues. It also shows the importance of a good blood splatter and aftermath experience, which are simply glorious in this game. And really, gory mess as exaggerated and as nasty as this shouldn't be unique to pixelated games. We have it here and in Brutal Doom, and all I can think of is that this needs to be a thing in 3D games too. Hope you enjoyed watching the review. Let me know how you feel in the comment section, and if you like the video, subscribe and share it with your friends. You can find the link to all of my gore reviews in the video description. Until next time!